too many of you cry. Brother, brother.
Hi, my name's Gail Babcock. I'm the program director for Ferguson Youth Initiative. And right here is our center. We have the old firehouse, used to be the firehouse. They moved down the street. And we're glad to have you all visit us and see Ferguson. Thank you.
Brother, there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, Father, we don't need to escalate. War is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love and get here today. Picket lines and picket signs, don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see. Oh, what's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
Yeah, what's going
on? Some of these buildings along in here were, the glass was broken out during the riots. This mostly happened after the non-judgment came down. A lot of the panels that have already come down have been taken to the Missouri History Museum, and they're going to be displayed there. Coming up is the new fire department, and then the police station just past that on your left. Andy Warren Tire set up, let the protesters set up right out here in front for two, three months.
Right here?
Right.
We don't need to escalate.
Right down ahead is the memorial for Mike Brown.
See, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love and get here today. Picket lines and picket signs, punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see. Oh, what's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
What's going
on? Yeah, what's going on?
What's going on?
Oh, what's going on?
What's going on?
Right on.
He was walking in the middle of the street, but he was with one of his friends. The police told him to get on the sidewalk. He didn't want to get on the sidewalk, so then after that, the police got out the car. Then they got the tussling. Mike Brown, as they was tussling inside the car, the officer reached for his weapon, shot him while he was in the car. Then Mike Brown ran. As he was running down the street, the police officer shot more times. He dropped down to his knees and put his hands up, and the police also walked up on him and shot him again in his hand.
But I'm trying to think forward to what we can do.
Yes.
Youth communicating with police officers, just talking.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't have to have like a real relationship, but they at least should know who each other are.
These ribbons that's right here on the fence, it's, we put those up there just basically everyone writing a message to Mike Brown. Just basically expressing their feelings and letting everybody know that they have hope.
We recently had a youth summit. A youth summit is basically like what a youth, and we had a couple of police officers come in to where the youth can express their feelings and adults basically have to sit down and listen.
I am so sorry that your town became known for such an ugly incident. But it's not an incident that just happens here. Where some of these folks live in the city of Oakland has been known as the murder capital of the United States. We in our communities know violence too. And the violence that you experienced with Michael Brown, unfortunately, doesn't even get that kind of attention at home because it happens so often. Maybe not just like Oscar Grant. We had Oscar Grant there shot and stuff. But we have this kind of violence that is perpetrated. We wanted to come, my vision for coming here was to give you an opportunity to talk to each other, to see that this is not just about you living in Ferguson or us living in the Bay Area in California. This is a problem throughout the United States, and you guys are the young people that can change this. You have the ability to change. I want every person in here to know just how special you are. It doesn't matter whether you have a lot of money, no money, you are special people. And all you gotta do is step into that greatness, claim it. Claim today that you are great and you are gonna make a difference.
So I'm Dante Keel, a sophomore at De Anza High School.
I'm a sophomore at De Anza High School.
Excellent.
My name is Cam Lee. I'm a senior at De Anza High School.
The trip to Ferguson was a great experience because after you see what they've been through for the past month, they had most of their stores were torn down, burned down, and just they're trying to recover from something that almost seems impossible, but it is possible. And the reaction of most of them is going pretty well because they said they're getting along with most of the police officers there. And yet the experience at Ferguson was just amazing, seeing what they have been through and after, like the effect after all that happened.
So my experience at Ferguson was very eye-opening as to what happens anywhere in the world, really. I've had many experiences like this with many different subjects, but more specifically this one is very shocking. It's who would ever expect our own protectors to shoot us? I mean, they could have been afraid of the unknown, yes, but there are safer measures that could have taken than taking a person's life, which no one, not anyone, has the right to do. I think we can try to fix our image, so to speak. We can make it so, we can try fixing the stereotypes that have been set and are still being set to this day.
Okay, I feel that as a young African American, I'm stuck in a situation where, like Dante said, our protectors are kind of against us or they fear us. And there's only like so much that I can do to really change the situation. We talked about how if we make a relationship with the police officers in our area, then if we do ever get in trouble, that relationship will, they'd know who I am, so I wouldn't ever, I'd be able to feel a little safer like with them. But that's like, that only changes my situation, but there's so many other African Americans, like African American males out there who are, just police have like this stereotype about them that they want to not do, they want to do bad, I guess. They're not helping out the community. And we, as young scholars, we're all helping out our community.
For you.
Pulling your pants up, not sagging, talking like you have some sense, just having respect. Like if a police officer does pull me over, have respect for them, just say yes or no, sir. Try and not put myself in a situation where anything bad could happen to me.
I think the way we can change this, or I can change this, is by being successful and finishing, like getting an education and being dressed properly. Because most people say that people judge you by the way you dress, and I think that's very true. So if most of us were to dress like properly, we'll get treated as everyone else.
There's far too many of you dying. You know we've got